everybody, it's your boy BokaLoka320, and unfortunate news, guys. This game, with no release date or release window announced previously, has been slightly delayed. I know, guys. And it's horrible news to take with this unannounced game, with any kind of a release window being slightly delayed. But guys, I see people on Twitter flipping out. I see people that are anti-PlayStation just trying to get any kind of a nugget for their stupid channels and trying to turn this into something major. They're not going to E3. This whole year's screwed. You got PlayStation people panicking already that this is the worst year in like 4 or 5 years. And apparently, a generic fat ass who doesn't work on Twitter is a representation of the entire PlayStation community, right, guys? This is the nonsense we're talking about. That Xbox and all these other fans try to put out there to try to just twist shit, to try to be annoying, even when they lose, they can't lose a grace. And guys, I'm not saying this game's gonna be a smash hit, but you gotta respect who's creating, directing, writing, coding the game. That's Kojima and his army of people he brought from Kojima Productions that was still stuck at Konami being miserable, right? He brought all those talented people over, so I have no doubt in my mind it's at least going to be an 8 game. I don't know if it's going to be a Game of the Year game because, like the rest of y'all, I don't know what this is about. It's obviously a third-person open-world game. Mads Mikkelsen, you know, the guy who played Hannibal Lecter in Hannibal, the new series, you know, critically acclaimed series, and he played the villain in Casino Royale. He's a pretty accomplished actor. He leaked some multiplayer details, I think, on Twitter via press release, and he quickly got shut down by Kojima and said group. But that's all we know. It's a third-person open-world game with multiplayer functionalities. I'm guessing maybe like a From Software, you know, type of thing where a co-op, you get assistance, you see what other people did so it can help you further along in the game. I don't know, but to doubt this guy who people would have you think he's just a cutscene creator, like, let me be honest, like Quantic Dream and what's his name, David Cage. This guy, even if you played his games, his gameplay mechanics are far beyond the curve. They're always ahead of the time, whether it's Metal Gear Solid 1, Metal Gear Solid 2, which I hated because of that switch with Raiden over Solid Snake, but the gameplay mechanics are brilliant, ahead of their time. Same thing with Metal Gear Solid 5, right? And it's funny, that game had no cutscenes, no story, which is what people complained about it. You hired Kiefer Sutherland for no reason, but the game, gameplay-wise, was exceptional. So I have no reason to doubt, why this game would give us anything otherwise, man. Exceptional gameplay with whatever his wacky-ass imagination is coming up with, right, from watching all those millions of hours of movies. But to flip out and say, well, the gear's dry, the game's slightly delayed, so it's not coming out. Guys, it'll come out this year, it'll come out next year, it'll come out for PS5. This generation is already over. And you have plenty of games to play. This front year has been kind of loaded, as usual, because a lot of developers and publishers are taking suit and kind of copying PS4 strategy with the first-party titles. Just kind of get them out of the freaking busybody area of Call of Duty and all these other dumb shooters that come out in the fall. And just move them towards the open season where people, you know, genuinely it's a dry part of the year, right? The driest part of the year is the summer, but it started with start of the new year. It's not happening that way anymore. These big games are dropping in January, mainly by Capcom. And then you saw Kingdom Hearts 3. So you had Resident Evil 2, Kingdom Hearts 3, you had Metro. You have games to play. They're not Game of the Year games, arguably. You had Devil May Cry coming out to great reviews. Sekiro's getting some great previews, Game of the Year nods, apparently. Days Gone's looking better than people thought because, you know, they actually got hands-on with it for the first time. So, guys, it's not an empty year. You're still getting Dreams, even if you're not into it. You're still getting content. You're still getting Judgment, Yakuza spinoff, dual voice acting. You're getting content. You're getting stuff to play. So stop playing a victim. Idiots who are trying to bring down PlayStation for whatever reason, other than to try to drive attention to their stupid channels. You're being morons. You're not using facts. You're trying to incite a reaction based on basically stupidity. I don't know what to tell you guys, but whenever this game comes out, it's going to come out. And it's not going to stop y'all from enjoying all this other plethora of content that's coming out on PS4. So yeah, guys, let me know what you think, and let me know if you think it's actually the new fake outrage, I guess, for the meantime, until they find something new to stupidly complain about. But yeah, guys, I'm out. Be safe. Plug 320. Later.